a sense of irony.
The human body generates more bioelectricity than a 120-volt battery and over 25,000 BTUs of body heat. Combined with a form of fusion, the machines had found all the energy they would ever need. There are fields, endless fields, where human beings are no longer born. We are grown. For the longest time, I wouldn't believe it. And then I saw the fields with my own eyes. Watched them liquefy the dead so they could be fed intravenously to the living. And standing there, facing the pure, horrifying precision, I came to realize the obviousness of the truth. What is the Matrix? Control. The Matrix is a computer-generated dream world, built to keep us under control in order to change a human being into this.
No. I don't believe it. It's not possible.
I didn't say it would be easy, Neo. I just said it would be the truth.
Stop! Let me out! Let me out! I want out!
Easy, Neo.
Get this thing out of here. Get this thing out of here.
Back one more. Can I see them side by side?
See, that doesn't help. When they're side by side, I don't know which one I prefer.
Yo, why do you want them to have blue eyes anyway?
All the actors of any renown have blue eyes.
No, they don't.
Matt Damon, Leo, Gyllenhaal, Paul Newman, Sinatra.
Okay. Okay. If it means so much to you.
What are we even doing here if we're not fully committed to giving this kid the best shot at life? I heard in a podcast that blue eyes maximize the contrast of a pupil, which has been evolutionarily selected to convey greater emotional depth.
What do you think?
Oh, whatever you guys decide is best. But I do want to flag that blue eyes are one of our upgrades.
Yeah, of course they are.
Yeah.
How much?
Oh, I have to ask the man upstairs.
Would you be so kind?
Oh, sure.
Okay, don't think too much about this. Tell me the first number that comes to your mind.
Okay.
How much are we willing to spend on upgrades?
10.
1,000?
Cents. Yes, 1,000.
We want to get the maximum bang for our buck, and that's a very respectable number.
So glad you agree.
So, blue eyes is an $11,000 upgrade.
Hmm. And what comes standard?
Brown.
Okay, can we put a pin in that and come back to it at the end?
Sure, yeah. Also, we haven't got it listed. When are you guys looking to conceive?
Oh, we were hoping to meet the Gladwellian window, which would make it...
April 10?
Yes, that's it.
And what's the latest we can pull the trigger?
April 1st.
Oh, of course it is.
Now, I know these are really big.
Tourists. Tourists that turn tourists taking photos. Tourists. Tourists that turn tourists taking photos.
Here are things you need to know about the future of designer babies. You are made up of a sequence of thousands of genes. Genes are like the code to your computer program. You change the code and you change the program. Gene editing will allow you to select the desired genes and design your own baby. In the future, you will be able to select their personality, gender, and possibly their IQ. Here are things you need to...
There's a term now called designer babies. This is not fashion designer babies. They're able to choose the gender of the baby, the hair color of the baby. They're able to choose if the baby's going to be tall or short. You can change your baby and the baby's going to come out the way you want it. What I find really crazy about this is, you know how like super rich people get like all the surgery and you can kind of tell like, you spend money part, on... Yeah. I think it would get to a point where you would kind of look at a kid and already know that kid comes from money because the attributes that they chose, this is a start. Because what's going to end up happening is they're going to be able to put better memory in. They're going to be able to put smart genes in. It's like everything. This opens the floodgate to a bunch of there's a term.
After 3 years in prison, the scientist who was arrested for creating the world's first genetically engineered babies is set to be released soon. In largely secret research, He used a genome editing technology called CRISPR to edit the DNA of human embryos. The embryos were then implanted into two women and led to the birth of three so-called designer babies. This led to a huge ethical debate in the scientific community as some expressed outrage over concern for the baby's health, which we still don't know, and others saw it as an opportunity to push forward in research into editing the human genome. Critics say the technology is playing God and could lead to eugenics as well as unintended health consequences in the babies, but proponents say that it could be used to eliminate disease-causing mutations before birth.
Base, money, fancy clothes, ops and coppers I dispose, talk slow, lower your tone.
Did you know the devil is now trying to create his own humans? Check at this. This is the first artificial womb where parents will actually be able to design their child. Wait till you see this intro video. Watch this.
Facility features 75 highly equipped labs. Each state-of-the-art lab can accommodate up to 400 growth pods or artificial wombs. Every pod is designed to replicate the exact conditions that exist inside the mother's uterus. A single building can incubate up to 30,000 lab-grown babies per year.
The Bible says that in the last days, it'll be like the days of Noah, where humans are actually being genetically modified. Subscribe now if you believe
babies are being grown like plants in a lab. Ectolife claims to be the world's first artificial womb facility, capable of growing 30,000 lab-grown babies a year, like a scene straight out of the Matrix. Only problem is, Ectolife is not actually a real company. And their CEO is actually just a film producer with a background in molecular biology. But he claims that everything mentioned in his Ectolife concept video is actually 100% possible and completely based in science. One of the things he mentioned is being able to track your baby's development in an app on your phone. Uber Eats? Pfft. You got that Uber baby. And use a gene editing tool that allows you to customize your baby's eye color, hair color, skin tone, physical strength, height, intelligence, you name it. Like giving your baby a customized loadout before they're even born. He claimed that the only thing that held this thing back from happening is a law stating that human embryos used for research need to be destroyed within 14 days for ethical reasons. But in May 2021, this law was actually off, so there's technically nothing holding it back from happening now. Hey, so who's down to make some super babies out there?
Introducing Ectolife, the world's first artificial womb facility, powered entirely by renewable energy. Ectolife allows infertile couple to conceive a baby and become the true biological parents of their own offspring. It's a perfect solution for women who had their uterus surgically removed due to cancer or other complications. With Ectolife, premature births and C-sections will be a thing of the past. Ectolife is designed to help countries that are suffering from severe population decline, including Japan, Bulgaria, South Korea, and many others. The facility features 75 highly equipped labs. Each state-of-the-art lab can accommodate up to 400 growth pods or artificial wombs. Every pod is designed to replicate the exact conditions that exist inside the mother's uterus. A single building can incubate up to 30,000 lab-grown babies per year. Ectolife allows your baby to develop in an infection-free environment. The pods are made of materials that prevent germs from sticking to their surfaces. Every growth pod features sensors that can monitor your baby's vital signs, including heartbeat, temperature, blood pressure, breathing rate, and oxygen saturation. The artificial intelligence-based system also monitors the physical features of your baby and reports any potential genetic abnormalities. The pods are equipped with a screen that displays real-time data on the developmental progress of your baby. These data are sent directly to your phone so you can track your...
Japanese scientists have just revealed that they are on the cusp of growing human babies in a lab. They claim it's going to be possible as soon as 2028. Now, these claims come after they recently made a scientific breakthrough creating 7 mice with 2 male biological parents. They did it by using the skin cells from one of the mice to form a viable egg, and then fertilize that egg using the other one. And what's crazier is that they believe they'll be able to do the same for a human egg in just 5 years. Now, in light of this prospect, some are saying that this is going to be an amazing development for human beings, saying that it would allow women to bypass the pain of childbirth, and they would no longer have to halt their careers. But others are raising ethical concerns, because firstly, it would mean that women of any age could have babies. It would open the door to gene editing, with every parent being able to pick their perfect child, down to their build, their hair and eye color, and even potentially their intelligence. And that's without considering what it would mean for how society organizes itself if women were no longer needed to have children, because now anyone could do it. And all of this combined with what's coming with Neuralink means we've got one wild future ahead of us. So the question is, do you agree with lab-grown babies, or should we put that shit on hold?
The first lab-grown infant didn't cry as it left the artificial womb. It just stared at the ceiling in horror and died shortly after. Footage of the birth revealed an invisible figure in white leaning over the infant, mumbling the word, rejected, in Old Akkadian. The first
For this one, we're going to talk about the possibility of the world's first artificial womb facility. And when I read the story, I was intrigued, I was excited for those who could benefit, and I was scared all at the same time. So I thought, yeah, I'm going to share it with you. There is a brainchild project for an artificial womb facility that lets you choose a baby's characteristics right any inherited genetic disease.
Introducing Ecto.
Japanese scientists say we may have lab-grown babies by 2028.
Japanese scientists are revolutionizing reproductive science by creating human sperm and eggs in the lab. This breakthrough may make it possible to grow babies in the lab. Professor Hayashi and his team created mice from male parents using vitro gametogenesis, IVG. By converting skin cells into viable eggs, fertilizing them, and implanting them into female mice, they conceived artificially bred mice. Although only 1% of embryos resulted in live mice, this research has groundbreaking implications. While still in its early stages, the creation of basic human sperm and egg cells in the lab is a significant milestone. Professor Hayashi believes human application is possible within 5 years, but safety and efficacy require further study. However, ethical concerns arise, but despite challenges, this breakthrough offers hope for those battling infertility. Stay curious and keep discovering more from Science Times.